Welcome and tell us what exactly you mean by oracles.
Oracles are basically messages. They are our personal communication that our higher beings are continuously sending us. Right from the time we begin to think, I think even before that, our higher crew is very busy constantly protecting and guiding us. Now, once we start thinking, we are understanding the power of thought and words. Our angels, our higher beings, the deities we worship, our spiritual guides, they want the best for us. And so they are constantly communicating with us in the form of thoughts, a brilliant idea you have, a song you hear on the radio, or probably a quote that you read somewhere. Sometimes, if you will be very intuitive or sensitive, you will understand that this is just the quote that you wanted to deal with to clarify a situation that you are going through. So basically, I feel oracles are everywhere, all around us, all the time. It's up to us how we interpret it, how we store it, how we feel about them, and how much we understand them.
So in a way, there are some forces or some higher beings which are always trying to get in touch with us. They're trying to say something.
Yes, they are constantly.
And cards are just a medium.
When we look at oracle cards, there are oracle cards for just about anything. There are cards that address life purpose. There are cards that address a guided action when we are facing choices. There are cards for romance. There are cards for family relationships. You have cards, you know, for mediumship also, for earthly matters, for abundance issues, for health. Lots and lots of decks are available. You need to pick up what suits your sensibilities, what appeals to you. Doreen Virtue appeals to me, so I guess that must be the connection. And so I use all the cards, and she has developed cards virtually on every situation. So whenever I have a situation, let's say I'm dealing with a health issue, then I will go to the Raphael card in order to know exactly what's happening here. If I need abundance issue, then I would pick up any of the decks, and mostly I will get the cards that says you'll get your money, or prosperity is coming to you now, or debts cleared, any of these cards which reflect abundance.
So can you share something at your personal level, some personal experience that you have had with cards or these messages?
Yes, I have had a very magical experience with the cards. The basic way they came into my life in itself was magical. This is the first deck that I have of Doreen Virtue. I remember being in this bookstore. At that time, I was exploring books on Reiki. I probably read everything that is available on Reiki. And so I remember praying in the morning and saying that, okay, I'm ready. If there is something more that I need to know, send it across. Something that will truly excite me. And then I remember going into this bookstore. I had no clue what oracle cards are. I had no clue whatsoever about Doreen Virtue that day. And I came up to the shelf, and somehow I saw these decks, and by curiosity, or let's say now, guided, I picked them up. And I just sort of looked at it, read about it, and I wondered what it is. And then there was a corresponding book with it. But at that time, we were on a little bit of budget. So taking the deck and the book seemed to be a little bit way too much going above my budget. So I kept the deck back and I thought I'd move from there. Some force, some unseen force, just wouldn't let me move. It was not like I was tied. It was not like somebody was dragging me. But I couldn't move from there. I had to just wait there. So I called my husband and I said, look, this is what I found. This is a little bit expensive as far as our budget for that moment. And he said, go for it, take it. And the moment I decided that I would take it, I took this deck in my hand and I could rock. And till date, it beats me. Why it should happen that way? But when I brought this deck, my life changed. A whole new set of sort of friends came into my life who would guide me into every situation. And now I virtually consult them sometimes on an hourly basis every day. My communication with them is daily, and they are very loving, very gentle, firm and honest. It's not all about just positive imagery. There are times when they pull you up. There are times when they tell you what to do. So we'll pull out a card and let us see what they have to say to us at this very moment. Here. Even the first card that comes to you is your oracle. So this card is telling me that whatever it is that I'm going to do in today's day, I'm going to have sort of a happy day. Still, let us say, I want to know more. It's like a conversation. So we'll pick out any card. The cards operate on law of attraction. So what I need, what I have focused in this very moment will come to me. Again, so it's not a coincidence. I am going to have a very happy day after all. Look inside yourself. Now, this is the card that basically is asking me to introspect, to look within myself and find those perplexing issues within me and resolve them so that I may come out of that web and grow for something more.
So Sunil, like you just said, that you consult the cards almost on a daily basis, sometimes on an hourly basis. In fact, I myself do it many a times. And so you are saying that people don't have to actually go to the cards only when they are in a crisis situation or they are stuck in something. They can actually do it in their day-to-day life.
Yes. Actually, in the beginning of, let's say 5 years before now, whenever I thought cards, I thought tarot. And it seemed very mystic, and it seemed that only few people do it. But now, thanks to the awareness, lots of cards, including angel tarot cards, are now available in the market. And so treat the cards as friends. With friends, you don't go only and only when you need some kind of drastic help. You sort of talk to your friends probably every day. From minor to major issues, you would share everything with them and take their insights on them. Not necessarily you will accept everything that they say, but you will value whatever it is that they say and you will think over it. Cards are the same. If, like me, you start consulting the cards on a daily or maybe let's say a weekly level, it's not necessary that they will, whatever they say is like a fixed word. Because you're constantly changing, your thoughts are changing, and your thoughts are the ones that create your reality. So your cards will also keep on reflecting this changing frame of your mind. And at any given point of time, they will tell you what is the next guided action. So let's say when I was dealing with an emotional issue, when I picked up this card, the card came, "Are you willing to forgive?" So it was like a question the cards asked me. Naturally, I was not ready. That is what the cards were reflecting. So they were asking me, "Are you willing to forgive?" 2 days later, again when I approached these cards with the same situation in mind, they gave me another card that said, "Be willing to forgive." That reflected again my frame of mind that sat and that said that, okay, in those 2 days, my mind had worked to that level where I was ready to think about that particular emotion. Now, 10 days later, of course, I meditated. I was working on forgiveness. I was working on asking for forgiveness as well as letting go of certain people. And when I did now pick up the cards, again, now another card that was shown, "Who are the people who are you willing to forgive?" So now it reflects that, yes, I'm ready to forgive. So I need to call to my mind, into my meditations, those people with whom I have to do forgiveness work. So at every given point of time, it is the cards that reflect. They are extremely patient. Their love for you is unconditional. They do not sit there and chide you that last time I advised you, you didn't listen. They are constantly providing you guidance. And so yes, you can subscribe to us for your weekly guidance. A sensitive card reader is absolutely a must to be able to interpret at what stage your mind works, because each card reflects not only an advice but also your readiness of the mind, of your heart, of your emotions to face a certain situation. So you can take a guidance weekly, you can take a monthly guidance. If you are guided to daily, then probably I would suggest you must learn to read the cards. Take one of the card reading courses probably, and you are going to have the best friends ever.